Hello, dear friends. It's Carly, and welcome back to Owning Authenticity. Thank you for being here with me yet again. And this video is a real quick few minutes to invite you to a live event that I am hosting on Saturday, November 20th at 11 o'clock Central Time. So if you can make it, everyone is welcome. It is an open Q&A session on human design. And really, when we say human design, it could be anything and everything under that human design umbrella. There is a lot to it. And I'm going to talk for just a couple minutes in case you're brand new to human design, about what is that and what does it include. So if you're familiar with your natal chart and the chart that shows the planets and where they were at the moment of your birth, that natal chart and those planetary placements is still the basis of your human design chart. There's a little bit more to it than that. It's actually a combination of systems, with the natal chart kind of being the foundation. And then it also adds on the I Ching, the Kabbalah, Tree of Life, the chakras. It's an amalgamation of all of them. So when you first look at the chart, just like natal charts, there's a lot of information that is held within that small space. So a couple of things. One, the main idea behind human design is that it is the science of differentiation. And it's this idea that individuals are exactly that. They are individuals. They are unique subsets of energy. And every single individual that is here, that is present and alive on this planet, has their own individual wiring. As humans, we have a basic energetic framework. We're a nine-centered being. We all have the same channels and gates of energy inside of us waiting to be activated. And then our planetary placements when we were born was an imprint of energy that wired our system in its own unique way. So human design is about seeing an actual picture of your energetic wiring. And there are so many different ways to slice and dice all of the information that's included. It starts like the most basic part is the type. So there are five types, and that type is describing your aura, the way that your energetic field that you carry, the way it works and the way that it talks and interacts with other people's auras. And that right there already can be eye-opening. Eye-opening. We'll leave it at that. And then moving on from there, there's inner authority. So like, where in your body do you go to make decisions for yourself? And depending on what that is how long does it take to get clear on whatever your decision is for yourself? How long of a process is that? Some inner authority, it's like in the minute, the answer is right there. It's very simple. And then later you can't get it back. You can't have that experience again. It's only in the moment. Different authority, which is the one I have, is emotional authority. And that means riding out the entire emotional wave, which can take days. And once the emotional wave has completed in its entirety, then you will have clarity around whatever it is that you're deciding. So for me personally, that's a good example of learning that I have emotional authority. The key to working with that and the experiment of working with that is to give myself time and space in making decisions, to not ever commit to anything in the moment, because my authority requires the full emotional wave to run its course, which will always take time. A lot of times, you know, that we can feel pressured to have to decide really fast. Or if somebody's like, hey, I want to have dinner with you tomorrow night, like, and, you know, then there's this social pressure to just say yes. And as an emotional authority person, the rule of thumb is like, don't say yes in the moment. Be like, ooh, yeah, that sounds fun. Can I think about it? Can I sleep on it? And I'll let you know tomorrow. And I've really had to practice doing that because I easily get excited about whatever anybody else is excited about. And then as I sleep on it, as I kind of sit with it for a while, it's like, oh yeah, I don't really feel like doing that. So creating that space for myself has been really impactful. And that is just one little snippet of all of the different information that there is in a human design chart. So if you haven't ever seen your human design chart, I will put in the description box a link to where you can go to get your own chart for free. You do need your birth time. So it'll ask you for your birthday, the birth time, and the location. And from that information, it calculates where the planets were at the moment of your birth and where they were 88 days before your birth. So that point, that 88-day point, has its own whole fun story, which we can totally get into on Saturday. But the combination of those 2 days kind of comes together to form both your conscious personality, the version of yourself that you know, and then also your unconscious self, the version of yourself that includes like all of the ancient downloads from your ancestors and all of the signature wounds that you came to heal and the gifts that you inherited that you came to share. And they say that we grow into that unconscious side of ourselves kind of in our 30s, 40s, 50s. As we get acquainted inside of our energy, that hidden part of ourself naturally rises to the surface. So there is so much depth with natal charts. And I love natal charts. If you've heard me talk, like I haven't moved on from natal charts. I very much see human design as just one more side to the beauty of studying yourself and understanding the unique way that your energy works so that apart from anything that's going on in the world around you, you can stand firm inside. This is who I am. This is what I need. This is how I function. And you can love yourself through that process because you understand this is how I'm wired and become a cooperative component working with your energy instead of fighting against it, which I don't know about you, but for me, it was definitely a thing for quite a while. So the other thing that I left in the description box for you, and this is whether you can make it to the Q&A session or not, is I do have a video series on the channel called Simplifying Human Design. And the goal is very much to put little chunks of knowledge into these videos, bite-sized pieces, so that you can begin dissecting and understanding what you're looking at in your human design chart. So by all means, check out that playlist, explore that knowledge further. And I hope you can make it on Saturday. Either way, sending you good vibes. Until next time, you take good care of yourself. And so will I.